Reported to have disappeared on the eve of the wedding with his best man, current whereabouts still unknown. What a sensation. Daryl? What have you done with him?
Moi?
Yes, you.
What makes you think I've got anything to do with it?
Oh, come on, Daryl. This has got your grubby little chalky-stained fingers all over it.
Well, that marriage would never have worked anyway.
Daryl, this was going to be the society wedding of the century. Just think. The church, the flowers, the veil, the white lace, the long flowing satin gown.
And what was the bride going to wear?
Nice coming from you. I thought you were supposed to be his best man.
I am his best man. I'm his best man. He said I was the best man he'd ever had.
You're just awful. What would he see in you anyway, Daryl? I mean, can you name me one thing, one tiny little thing that you've got that she doesn't have? Anyway, they were so much in love.
Oh, how would you know anyway?
Did you see the size of her ring?
Well, you weren't even invited. I mean, that's the fact, you weren't invited.
Doesn't matter, I was going to crash the reception anyway. Had it all worked out. Rostered onto London, Frankfurt, connecting flight to Venice, taxi to the Palazzo, grease up to one of the guards and slip straight in the back door.
Well, we can. Well, we can count ourselves lucky that little scheme was foiled, can't we? I mean, I've seen you at these things with a couple of glasses of spumante. You're down on your knees with your tongue hanging out. You're anyone's. Or I should say everyone's.
Oh, now, come on. Anyway, what have you done with it?
Loose lips sink ships.
Yes, I know, but what have you done with it?
Well, I've stuffed him in the forward baggage hole.
This is a 30-hour non-stop long haul. He'll starve to death.
I know, and it's all right. I've made provisions. I've given a cask of bread and a loaf of bread and the biggest cabana you ever did see.
He should be as happy as Larry, then.
No, well, Larry is down there, too.
Oh, no.